Let's talk about butts.
I could go into a song right now.
Good morning, everyone. Keep Athens limestone beautiful. We're talking about big butts, cigarette butts. That is Miss Lynn Hart with me this morning. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. You guys have had fun with this.
We have.
Even though it's not a fun subject.
No, it's not.
It's one of our pet peeves.
I was going to say, it's one of your favorite topics.
It is, because it's so annoying when you see people when you're pulling out somewhere you're driving, or they take their ashtray and they just dump it out, or that's just bad.
Well, you know, the thing about cigarette butts is they're very small and...
You think they're harmless.
Well, people who would never think of throwing a Coke can or a McDonald's bag out...
Usually not your typical litter.
...wouldn't think twice about flicking that cigarette butt out the window or throwing it down and stomping it out on the ground.
And leaving it there.
Yes, and most of the time it's because they just don't know. And so we are using these giant butts to call attention to the problem of cigarette litter. And I want to make it clear right from the start, this is not a stop smoking campaign. We'll leave that up to other people. What we're talking about today is if you are a smoker, to please be responsible with your cigarette litter.
Why is it so bad for the environment?
There are a couple things. First of all, some people think that the filter is made of cotton and it just melts in the rain or just goes away. But the filter is actually made of plastic, which means that that filter hangs around in the environment as long as any other kind of plastic would hang around. The other thing is, and it causes clogs. They get down the sewers and they clog sewers and drainage ditches. And also, those filters are designed to trap some of the hundreds, if not thousands, of poisons and chemicals that are in burning tobacco. Okay. And so it gets trapped in there, and when you throw them down and they get rained on or washed into our blown or washed into our sewers or our water systems, all those poisons and chemicals wash out of that filter and into the environment. Well, cigarette litter is small. These are a little bigger than normal, but they're small, and so people don't think. But trillions are littered every year. Not millions, not billions.
Trillions.
Trillions. So if you think about that, and think about, the amount.
And they're a fire hazard as well.
Absolutely. We have one of the giant butts. Each one of them has a message on it. Mm-hmm. And one of them says, quote, "Gee, I wonder how that grass fire started," said the driver as he flicked his cigarette butt out the window. Because, you know, that can so easily happen, especially in the summer when the grass is dry.
It certainly can. We have a couple photos that you sent us. Actually, you started this campaign, not actually today, but you started it several weeks ago.
Right.
But there, of course, Trisha Black, Holly Holman, there you guys are, just having a little fun with this, trying to make awareness of it. And there's Mayor Marks, he even has his. Now, even if you do smoke, you know, and like Lynn said, she's not up here bashing you smokers. Just make sure you're responsible when you're getting rid of those cigarettes.
Now, this picture right here shows one of the new ash receptacles that Keep Athens Limestone Beautiful has purchased with grant money to go around the square.
Use them when you see them around town.
Yes. And what we and this picture right here, look how close that cigarette filter is to those dry corn stalks. And that's on the square. That could have been a disaster. Mm-hmm. There's another one of our butts at the Chamber of Commerce. We place these cigarette butts, the giant ones, strategically around the square next to all of the new receptacles that we purchased to call attention to where they are and why we want people to use them.
Wonderful. So if you happen to see them out there and you're with someone who's not familiar with what that is, just tell them, hey, that's the Big Butt Campaign. Have a little fun with it.
You know, earlier someone mentioned that they don't put ashtrays in vehicles anymore when they make them.
Greg was just telling us that.
Yes, and that's been a problem. And KALB has pocket ashtrays. Mm-hmm. We also have vehicle ashtrays that fit in a cup holder. And all you have to do is give us a call and make time to come in and see us, and we will give them away as long as supplies last.
There you go. Free ashtrays. Keep Athens limestone beautiful. Well, thank you for bringing your big butts up here this morning. We've had a lot of fun with it. Hope everybody at home has enjoyed it, too. And remember, if you see those little receptacles out, use them to put those cigarette butts in.
Please.
Thank you so much for being with us, Lynn.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we are going to take a quick break. Stay with us. We'll be right back.